Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today we've got something that I haven't done in a while, which is haul new makeup. I have been in a bit of a beauty rut over the last like month and a half with everything that's been going on in the world. I've felt really lethargic and disinterested in makeup. It's all felt kind of like, what is the point and why does it matter? But you know what? I've come full circle and now I'm back to this place where I feel like you just have to find the fun and the good in the little things, and makeup does make me happy. And even though no one's going to see me most days, it does feel good to put on a face of glam. So that's what we're gonna be doing today. I'm gonna be showing you guys all the new beauty stuff that I've picked up, some things from the 21 Days of Beauty sale from Sephora. I also picked up something from Zoeva, which is very exciting. And I'm gonna put it all on my face to create this look that I'm wearing now, share some thoughts with you guys on things as I test it out, and just have some fun and chill. As always, I love hearing from you guys, so definitely leave a comment, let me know how you guys are doing, if there's any video requests that you have. And yeah, on that note, let's get into the try-on haul and I'll show you guys how I made this look. Okay, so to save us some time, I've already done my primer, foundation, and my brows. I am slowly but surely trying to chug my way through this Pure Lisse BB cream, which is in my project pan for 2020. I probably will have an update for you guys on that at the beginning of May, because I didn't really start the project until the like very end of January. So even though we're already like into April, it hasn't actually been 3 months for me yet. So stay tuned for that. So let's move on to the first product that I've hauled recently, and that is the Milani Conceal and Perfect Long Wear Concealer. This has honestly been such a long time coming. I remember seeing the promo photos for this when it first launched and immediately being intrigued. Like, I put it on my like favorites list at Ulta as soon as it became available there, but I didn't buy it. And I think the only reason was because I had just tried out like the e.l.f. Camo Concealer for the first time, the L'Oreal Infallible one. They all launched kind of around the same time. We had like a whole rush of new concealers and then new foundations in 2019. Either way, today is the day. We're gonna finally give this a go. So I got the shade 120 Light Vanilla. I don't know if this is gonna be too light for me. It's so hard to shop for foundation and concealers online because you really can't tell from those terrible online digital swatches what something's actually gonna look like. But we'll hope for the best. So as far as an applicator goes, this has one of those kind of felted or flocked paddle style applicators. So it's not really a doe foot, but I actually like this style of applicator even better because you have more surface area to swipe the product on. So we'll give this guy a go. Does seem very creamy. I've heard from so many people that this is like a really beautiful concealer, that it covers well and it doesn't look dry and creepy and creasy on the under eyes. So that's kind of what I'm hoping for. And I'll just blend this in with my beauty blender here that I used for my foundation today. I think the color match is actually not horrible. It's a little light. It's definitely a brightening shade on me, but it's not like entirely ghostly pale and white. But the way that it's blending into my under eye area does look really nice. It doesn't seem dry and creepy. It seems pretty smooth. Yeah, I feel like that looks pretty nice. I definitely feel like if I was to add more powder on top of this, it might start to look a little bit dry. So I'm gonna just see if it sets itself and try not setting it. But I feel like the coverage is decent. It's not like insanely heavy full coverage. It reminds me kind of like the Maybelline Fit Me in the way that it finishes and the way that it covers. So far, so good. I actually think that looks really pretty nice. So I am pleased with the Milani concealer based on my first impression. Obviously, I'm gonna need to see how it wears and, you know, continue to test it out. But on first application, I feel like it looks pretty nice. Okay, so I'm just gonna leave that concealer as is. I'm not gonna set it. And the rest of my face is pretty set down. I'm still doing that technique that I just shared in a recent video of putting my powder on top of my primer underneath my foundation. And guys, I'm really still liking it. What I've decided now is that I actually don't need to put the powder all over my face because the perimeter of my face is actually not very oily at all. So I'm just setting down my T-zone with the powder, and that seems to be working really, really well, because then the rest of my face stays kind of looking a little bit less heavy, and I just am putting like that extra oil controlling in where I need it. And then I feel like my foundation sets down completely without needing to like layer more powder on top of it. It's pretty cool. So we're just gonna move right on in to bronzer. I have been really, really liking this ColourPop single that I tried out in that video, the shade Afternoon Delight. I think this is such a pretty bronzer shade. It's definitely a little bit warmer, more summery. It's not really a contouring shade. That's kind of why I like it, because honestly, I haven't really been outside very much recently with quarantine days, so I kind of want to pretend that it's summer and I've been out at the beach or out of the park, you know, just channel all of those good vibes. So I'm just gonna go in with this multi-purpose powder brush from Moda. This is from their Green Crackle collection, which launched around the holidays. It's super pretty. I'll just warm up the perimeter of my face. And I think that's pretty good. I feel like that gives me a nice little wash of color, a nice little bronzed glow. So now it is time to move on to another product that I picked up that I am very excited about. So this is something I snagged from the Ulta 21 Days of Beauty sale. I was able to get my hands on one of the Cover FX monochromatic blush duos. I got the shade Soft Peach. And it's funny, I was kind of between this and the Pink Dahlia shade, but by the time that I went to go and order this, Pink Dahlia was already sold out, so that kind of made the decision for me. And let me tell you guys, I got up at 6 o'clock in the morning Eastern time to buy this, and it was kind of like a crazy fluke. Like, I knew when I went to bed that I wanted to get up and buy this first thing in the morning, but normally I wake up around 7 now that I don't have to commute into work. But I just kind of woke up naturally on my own extra early, and I'm glad that I did, because by like 7:30, pretty much all the shades were already sold out. So I'm just gonna like take that as a sign from the universe that this was meant to be in my life. And I am very excited to try it out for the first time on camera. So first of all, aesthetically, is this not such a beautiful product? The packaging, I forget who it was, maybe Mel Thompson described these as looking like little bars of soap. It has a nice kind of like soft touch packaging to it. And then you have the really pretty embossing in the shimmery side of the duo. So my understanding is that these are both blush shades, but the shimmery shade is meant to be used more as like a blush topper, so you can wear them individually or layer them together and kind of create the look that you want. So I think what I'm going to do today is go in with the matte side first so you guys can see it, and then we'll maybe layer on a little bit of the shimmery side on top. I'm going to be using this old retired Sonia Kashuk blush brush that I love so very much. This is like my favorite blush brush, but they don't make it anymore. It was so devastating when Sonia Kashuk like stepped out of her own brand at Target. Like, they still make it, but she's actually not associated with it anymore, and they discontinued all the brushes from her original collection. It's very sad. Anyway, let's get back to blush application. I'm just going to sweep this. On my cheeks, I went in very light to start because I wasn't really sure how pigmented this was going to be. I think this is the lightest duo of all of them. Yeah, it's definitely layering up though. On a second pass, now you're really seeing the color. As far as kick up goes, actually not super bad. Oh yeah, and there's the pigment. I went in a little bit heavier second time around. That is pretty though. I really like that color. It is very flushed, very springy. I feel like it's looking maybe just ever so slightly patchy, which could be the base that I'm wearing. Obviously, that's kind of the downside to doing a first impression. You don't know how much is the product itself or how much it is it playing with the other products on your face, but it's not bad. I'm just gonna go in with my little powder puff here and kind of just use the residual powder that's on here to kind of tap things out at the perimeters, just make sure everything is blended. Take a little residual also where I put the bronzer. I feel like that just kind of ties everything nicely together. I think that's pretty. I have a feeling I will get a fair amount of use out of this shade. So now let's go ahead and pick up a little bit of the shimmery side here. And let's see what happens when I add a little bit of that on top. So the glow is very subtle, but that's kind of what I would expect. Like, it's visible. I definitely can see that it is changing the finish to give it just a little bit of a sheen. But I feel like it's not so much that I couldn't also wear a highlight with this. Like, some glowy blushes are so glowy that you almost feel like a highlight would be overkill. I don't really feel like that's the case with this. I think maybe if I really like layered it up, it could be pretty intense. But I think if you want to switch things up and add just like a little bit of extra sheen, layering this on top does work pretty nicely. So speaking of highlight, let's add a little bit of glow. Now this is something I don't think I've shown on my channel yet. It's a really OG product, but I got it in my very last BoxyCharm box that I got back in February. And this is one of those products that I remember from old school YouTube that so many people raved about, but I never tried. And that's the Laura Geller Baked Gelato Swirl Illuminator in the shade Gilded Honey. So I put this in my everyday makeup drawer and have been using it over the last month and a half or so. And I really like it. It's a really, really beautiful highlight. It's just so funny because, again, this is one of those products that people don't really talk about so much anymore, but it was so loved for such a long time. And now I understand where all the fuss came from, because I do think that it is really pretty. It actually kind of reminds me in a way of the new Nabla Skin Glazing Highlight, like the consistency, the texture of it. It's got that very similar, you know, baked stiff formula that goes on very thin and blends really nicely into the skin. So it doesn't enhance texture in the same way I feel like as a more kind of thick, silicone-y, creamy highlight would. Lovely. I feel like my skin has that very almost like glass-like finish to it when I'm looking at my face in the viewfinder. I dig it. Okay, so next I'm gonna go ahead and prime my eyelids with a little bit of my MAC Soft Ochre Paint Pot because we have a new eyeshadow palette to test out that I'm pretty jazzed about. I picked up the new Natasha Denona Mini Retro Palette, and this is actually gonna be the very first time I'm ever trying a Natasha Denona eyeshadow. I know. Her stuff is just really, really expensive, and I do know that these like mini palettes and the like little smaller, more curated palettes that she's made are a little bit more budget friendly, but I don't know, for whatever reason, most of them just haven't really called to me and just didn't really seem like a smart investment anyway, so I just have been sleeping on the brand this entire time. But for some reason, I saw this and it just intrigued me. Maybe it's the pink packaging because I'm like obsessed with pink, I don't know. But the color story to me also was unique because you have this like grayy, greeny, taupey color against the soft pinks, and I feel like we've been seeing so much pink with purple, or like Sun City tones, pinks with oranges, pinks with yellows, that this was to me just a little bit more unexpected, and I was really into it. So I had a gift card to Sephora that I've been holding on to for a while, waiting for something that I actually wanted to buy, and I decided that this was the thing that I was gonna pick up. Also, Mel Thompson gave it rave reviews, because the other thing about these little mini palettes that have kind of deterred me from buying them is that they've seemed to really like hit or miss as far as the quality goes. It seems like some of them have not really been very good at all or very similar to her bigger palettes, and I kind of felt like it wouldn't be a good way for me to try the brand if I was trying a product that was inferior to her like larger palettes. So I've stayed away from a lot of those, but this one I feel like the community has generally had really good things to say about, so I'm excited. That being said, let's maybe do some swatches and see how this feels. So the first shade I'm dipping into here is, I believe, called Pixie. This one is kind of like a satiny pink. Ooh, very pretty, very smooth. This one definitely, yeah, has a sheen, but it's not like crazy foiled. Then you have this really, really beautiful dusty pink matte. Ooh, that one does feel really buttery. This one reminds me a little bit of the shade Labyrinth from ColourPop, which is one of my favorite shades. That's like the most gorgeous crease transition. So this one seems a little patchy in the way that it's swatching, but then again, the back of my hand is super bony, so I'm sure that's not helping anything. So then we have the grayy green color, and then this like grayy sparkle. That one feels incredible. So let's see how those look. Yeah, again, pigment, but like a little patchy. This shimmery shade though, ooh, that is gorgeous. I absolutely love that kind of color. It is, to me, like the perfect smoky eye, kind of sparkly shade. I'm not really a huge fan of straight up silver. I feel like that one can look a little harsh, things that are almost like a tinfoil silvery kind of color. But this, to me, it's got like that balance of taupiness. It's like a little bit more warm than just a straight up silver. Super flattering. And then last but not least is this like almost duochrome ethereal sparkly shade. That one to me also looked incredible. And it's seriously even prettier in person than it looks online because it has these almost like blue green micro shimmers in it. Oh, yeah, I honestly feel like you can't even see how gorgeous it is on camera. It's something that I think if you just like layer it on top of even like this pink shade to add extra sparkle, it'll look beautiful. Now, if that wasn't fun enough to play with all on its own, I also bought myself something that I have been wanting for a really long time and am very excited about, and that is a set of Zoeva makeup brushes. Zoeva was having a sale, all their brushes were 20% off and they had free shipping, and I said to myself, you know what, it's just time to take the plunge. Yes, there are a few Zoeva brush sets available on the Ulta website, but there hasn't been one of them that's like really called to me, and they're still a little bit expensive. But then when I saw this one on the Zoeva website and I realized that I could get it without paying an arm and a leg for shipping, I was like, yes, I'm all about that. So this is the IC brush set. These are the brushes that came inside of it. So you get six different ones. These are a mix of natural goat hair bristles and synthetic bristles. I don't own a lot of natural hair bristle brushes, but I do feel like they can be really nice, especially for blending like matte powder shadows. They just have a way of picking up product that I feel like it's just a little bit superior to synthetic. Like, you can get a really good synthetic brush, but the few animal hair brushes I've tried have been really nice. So I really wanted to give these a go and see what I thought of them. And also, I just love the color and the aesthetic of these with like the matte brushed gold and like the, again, the dusty rosy pink. It like looks so aesthetically pleasing with this palette, does it not? So I'm gonna start the look by going in with this 228 Luxe Crease Brush, and I'm gonna pick up the shade Vintage Taupe, which is the light matte dusty pink. And I'm gonna start this in the crease using soft circular blending motions and really, really light pressure. So I will say that I am noticing a very small amount of patchiness. As I'm layering and blending, it is getting better, but the initial laydown especially was a little bit patchy. And I feel like part of that is just the way that this is gripping to the MAC paint pot. You know, the way it swatched, it was a little bit patchy to start. It kind of had that ability to stick down to where the initial laydown was, even though like the back of my hand isn't primed. But it is slowly but surely buffing out nicely, and it definitely is, going on with a nice level of intensity. It's not blending away, so I appreciate that. And the brush is doing a great job. I really like, actually, that this has almost like a point to the tip. A lot of crease brushes are very round at the top, but this one, because it has a little bit of a point, you can kind of do more detailed blending, especially when you get closer to the inner corner of your eye. You can pull the brush back and use a lot less pressure to just create like a really soft gradient. All right, so next I'm gonna take the 231 Luxe Petite Crease Brush, and we'll go into this center shade here, which is called 60s, which is that grayy, greeny taupe. It's interesting because online I thought this was more of a green. It's not really. It's like this greenish, grayish taupe shade. It's kind of like a weird amalgamation that's not exactly gray or green or taupe, but somewhere perfectly in the middle of all three. So I am going to put this in the outer corner, use this as a deepening shade, just gonna concentrate it on the outer corner. I'm blending it a little bit into the deepest part of my crease, and then I'll make sure to go back with the other shade in the first brush to make sure everything is nicely blended together. All right, so this is the thing that I'm very curious about. I want to see how this shimmery gray shade picks up on a flat brush. So this is the 239 Luxe Soft Shader, and I'm curious to see if we just get some sparkle or if we actually get some serious pigmentation with this. It does look like it's picking up fairly well on the brush, so that's promising. And I'm gonna just try patting this onto a dry eye to see how it looks. I'm gonna use a glitter primer on the other side to see if there's a difference, just because that's normally what I would do with this type of shade, but I just wanna see how it performs all on its own. Definitely not bad. I mean, it's not like just a sheer wash. I do think I probably would be able to intensify it by adding the glitter primer, but I'm also not getting a ton of fallout, which is nice. This brush is pretty good about grabbing onto the product, it seems. And so if you really just pat and press it onto the eye, you don't get a lot of fluff and like glitter kicking up everywhere. So for ha-has, I'm gonna take some of my NYX glitter primer that I absolutely adore. We'll get a little flat synthetic brush, and I'm just going to apply this on my other lid, and let's see what the difference is like. Okay, so what I would say is that the glitter primer definitely intensified like the base pigment in this. It actually looks darker than it does on this eye. This eye looks like more light reflective and shimmery. This eye looks more metallic. So if you want a, like a deeper, smokier look, maybe the glitter primer works. But honestly, using this just with a dry brush still does give a really pretty finish. And I bet you if I like just went in with my finger and just kind of tapped this on, it intensifies pretty much the same way as it does with the glitter primer. So this is a really nice shade, I would say, overall. Like, it definitely performs really well on its own, so you don't need to use a glitter primer if you don't want to. I like them because I feel like they generally just help things kind of last a little bit longer, but it seems like this is one you could just put on a dry eye and it's gonna do pretty well for itself. All right, so I'm just gonna go ahead and perfect things a little bit. Go back in with this darker shade, deepen up that outer corner, intensify things a little bit that got lost with that dark shimmery shade. Overall, I do think the look this is giving though is very pretty. I am totally digging the color combination. Gonna take some of this pink matte on the lower lash line as well, and then maybe go in with the very tip of this petite crease brush, which again comes to a really nice point, and I'll just smudge this on the lower lash line too. All right, and then because I cannot resist this duochrome shimmery pinky topper kind of shade, I'm gonna pick up a little bit of this on my finger, and I'm gonna see what happens if I like just tap this on top. Ooh, it doesn't really add like a pink sheen. It adds, if anything, like a green shift. I feel like a lot is still sticking to my finger though. It's not really coming off too much. Maybe that's just because I can't really like swipe it without removing the eyeshadow underneath. But it does seem to be doing a little bit of something. I'm gonna try using a little pencil brush because there is not one in my Zoeva set. This one's from Moda. I'm gonna just swirl that in here and try buffing it into the inner corner. See how that looks. Yeah, this shade is definitely a lot more sheer and sparkly. It's pretty though. I feel like it would be cool to try layering this one over a glitter primer to see kind of the effect that that gives. Maybe I'll try that next time. So I think to finish off these eyes, I'm just gonna go ahead and smudge a little bit of black liner on my upper and lower lash line. I don't really wanna do a wing. Then I'll add some mascara and maybe some falsies. I feel like falsies could be fun. All right, you guys, so the eyes are done. Man, these freaking lashes, I love them so much. These are the Kiss Naked Drama lashes in the style chiffon. Ugh, stunning. Right now you can get these on the Ulta website for like $4. They are some of the best drugstore lashes I have ever tried. Would recommend them like a million times over. And specifically, the Naked Drama collection. I've tried some of the other lines from Kiss, but the bands on the Naked Drama ones specifically are super, super flexible and so comfortable. They're just like some of the nicest lashes that are so easy to apply and they're so beautiful. I also really like the style tulle a lot too. They're a little bit shorter and denser, whereas these ones are a little more long and wispy, but oh man, A++. And I feel like really just takes the eye look to the next level. All right, you guys. So to finish off this look, we just have to do lips. And I do have a couple new lip products to share with you. The first was actually a freebie that I got when I picked up this palette from Sephora. You know, they let you enter in a coupon code with a $25 purchase or more. So I got a free NARS Velvet Lip Pencil in the shade Rakugian, which I used to have this like 5 years ago or so, and I remember it being really pretty, but it's been a while since I've had it, so I'm excited to have that again. And then the other freebie that I got in that purchase was a point perk that I redeemed 100 points for, because honestly, even though most of the things that Sephora has available for points I feel like are not worth it, this one was. I got a mini of the Ilia Limitless Lash Mascara. I love this mascara so, so much. And you guys might remember I got pink eye back at the beginning of January. So I had to get rid of the little tube that I had of this that I'd only maybe used for like 2 weeks. I was really bummed. So now I've got a fresh new tube in the new packaging. I did not use it today though, just because I just opened this Joa Lash Uprising Mascara to test it out. So I want to wait till I go through this and my L'Oreal Lash Paradise, those are the ones that I currently have open, before I use and contaminate another new mascara. So those are my Sephora freebies. And then I also ordered during the Ulta 21 Days of Beauty sale a lip gloss from Smashbox that was, I think, 30 or 40% off. And this is something that I had seen in the store, had swatched, had thought about buying like 6 months ago, and then didn't. And I'm kind of glad I waited because now I got it on sale. So this is the Smashbox Los Angeles lip gloss, and I got the shade Actors Guild, which is this gorgeous, really super sparkly kind of champagne-y bronze. I thought this just looked absolutely stunning. I'll give you guys a little swatch. So it's definitely a sheer gloss, but it's very, very shiny. It has lots of little light reflective particles in it. So I thought it would be really nice to layer over a lipstick. I don't know that this is gonna go necessarily with the look that we're doing today, but I feel like this lip pencil probably will. So why don't we go in with the NARS? Because again, yeah, this is something that I haven't used in a really long time. See if I've changed my mind about it. Oh, hello. Pigment. Okay. Wow, that is super creamy, very glidey, and very pigmented. Does it smell like anything? No. It kind of smells a little plasticky, like a little bit like crayons, but there's obviously no added fragrance or flavor in here. Yeah, that is a gorgeous color. Definitely kind of like a soft berry pink. Feels super, super lightweight while also being hydrating on the lips. Yeah. That's really, really nice. I know these are a super popular product, but again, they have been around for such a long time that I feel like nobody talks about them anymore. But man, that is like really nice. If this launched a week from now, people would be all over it. Maybe I can just like take a little bit of this off the back of my hand, this gloss, and we'll just tap it. Add a little like a sparkle. Not sticky, which is nice. All right, you guys, so here is my completed final look, testing out some new makeup products that I've purchased recently. I'm really, really liking it a lot, actually. Everything, I think, is looking really beautiful. So let me take the ears off, zoom you out a little bit, and then we'll wrap things up with some final thoughts. So first was the Milani Conceal and Perfect Concealer. So far, so good. I feel like my under eye area is looking pretty good. I did not set this at all with powder and nothing has moved around. It hasn't creased. I do have fine lines in my under eyes and I feel like they are something that, you know, you're never going to hide completely, but they don't look really badly exaggerated or really crepey or anything like that. So So far, so good with this one. Then there was the Cover FX Monochromatic Blush Duo. I really like this shade Soft Peach. I think it's really pretty. It's very springy. I feel like now that it's kind of had a little time to set into my face, it's looking really nice with the rest of my makeup. We'll see how long wearing it is or whether or not I notice that it fades or turns orange or weird on me after a few hours. And even if it does wear really nicely, like, I'm glad that I got it at the sale price. I do still think it's a little bit much to spend $38 on this, knowing how many other amazing blushes are out there on the market for cheaper. Then there is the Natasha Denona Mini Retro Palette. I think that the color story of this is absolutely beautiful. I really love the smoky, glamorous eye look that I came up with today. I do feel like $25 for a 5-pan eyeshadow palette is a little bit pricey. I do think this is a nice way to try the Natasha Denona eyeshadow formula without shelling out $60 or $100+ for a palette. However, I will say that I don't really feel like the quality of these shadows is superior to things that are less expensive. Like, when I think about ColourPop eyeshadows, especially the mattes that are in here, I feel like ColourPop mattes perform very similarly at a much lower price point. And the metallics in here are also really beautiful, but they remind me quite a bit of like the metallic shades in my Nabla palettes that also have that really reflective, sparkly quality to them. So I'm definitely happy to have this. I don't think that it's a bad palette. I do think with it being a mini palette, you know, it's gonna be a little bit limiting as far as the types of looks that you're gonna be able to create with this. You're basically gonna either go the way that I'm going right now and do smoky glam, or you can do something soft and pink, but then those are kind of your only options. So unless you're someone that likes doing the same makeup look every single day, this may not be necessarily like the one and only palette to have, but it is really nice if you were traveling for like a weekend or something like that. Not that any of us are going to be doing that for a while. So yeah, happy I have it, happy I got to try the brand, enjoying this palette, but I don't necessarily feel like these shadows are above and beyond a lot of other things that I've tried. These brushes, though, are beautiful. I love the way that they performed. They were very soft, but they also picked up product and blended it out really beautifully. Even though I feel like this Natasha Denona palette was, if anything, a little bit patchy, I feel like I was able to make it work that much easier with these blending brushes. This set, I believe, normally retails for $50-something, maybe around $60. I paid $48 for it with the 20% discount, so do that math. So I definitely feel like for the money, this is a really nice brush set to invest in. I think each brush ended up coming out for me to less than $10, and I feel like they're definitely deserving of that price point. They remind me a lot of Sigma brushes, which are very similarly priced. If anything, I might like some of these a little bit better even than some of my Sigma brushes, just because of the cuts of these. I really like how the blending brushes have a pointed tip to them, so you can kind of use them in a little bit more versatile ways. They allow you to have more precision than a brush that has just like a regular rounded top. So yeah, really happy with how these performed for the first time. I've heard that these last forever and they wash and hold up really, really well, and that's part of the reason why they're such a good investment. So I mean, I have yet to test that out, but I will certainly keep you guys posted on, you know, how I like these as I continue to use them. And then the lip products. This guy, amazing. Such a beautiful color, such a beautiful formula, something I definitely feel like I need to revisit. Maybe if I'm going to buy some more lip pencils in the future, I'll consider buying some other shades of that, because dang, it's pretty. And the gloss is nice, but honestly, I feel like a gloss from Milani probably would do like just about the same thing, like the Keep It Full Nourishing Lip Plumpers that they have. I feel like those are similar to this, or like the new Ludacris lip glosses. I haven't tried those yet, but I feel like from the pictures I've seen, they seem very similar to this with how shimmery they are. So I don't know. There's nothing really super special about this. It doesn't smell amazing. It feels nice, but it's not like crazy special. I'm glad I didn't get it at the full price. I don't think it'd be worth $18. So yeah, good. Not mind-blowing. I'll, you know, try it out again, see what I think of it, but I have a feeling that this is not going to become like my new favorite lip gloss. So yeah, that is everything for me today, guys. Those are all of the products that I've hauled recently. Let me tell you, doing some retail therapy felt pretty good after like a month and a half of being really just bleh and like disinterested in makeup and beauty stuff. Like, it feels really good to be excited again and to be filming again. So I hope you guys enjoyed seeing all those products in action and hearing my initial thoughts on them. If you did, I hope you will consider giving this video a thumbs up. I always really appreciate your support so, so much. And if you are new and you're not subscribed to my channel and you'd like to see yours truly in your subscription feed, I hope you will consider clicking that button before you go. But yeah, on that note, I'm gonna let you guys go, but I hope you all are doing well. I hope you and your loved ones are staying safe and are able to stay connected, even if it's virtually during this time. I'm thinking of you all. I'm sending all of my love and positive vibes your way. So I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day, and I will see you in my next video. Bye, guys.